Hello, I'm going to talk to you today about conditional color or the use of color rules. To illustrate that, let me talk to you first about the problem. This is an example where I've created several cards, all from the same data set. And in this case, the jackets category happens to be shown in a green color. Right next to it, it is shown in a different color. And in the third card, you can see the jackets category is again in a different color from the original green. So what I want to show you is how you can make color your friend and make it work better for you inside of your chart building. So I'm going to click on this card and go into Analyzer. Then I'm going to click on Color Rules. Inside of Color Rules, it automatically selects the column that's being charted, so product type. I want to say every time I see the jackets category, I want to fill it in with this purple color so that it's consistent everywhere. Then I can choose to apply it to only this card, or I can apply it to all cards that are built from this data set. In this case, I'm going to say apply it to all cards. So now you can see here that the jackets category is highlighted in this light purple color. If I save and close the card and go back to my sales page, I can see that the jackets category is shown in purple on every card from this data set, even down to the table card where the jackets category is referenced. You can also use color rules to show values. This card shows how many of each product was sold this year. This time, instead of going by product category, I'm going to set a color rule for number. I'm going to set it to greater than or equal to 100 and make the color green this time. Then I'm going to add another color rule where the number is less than 100. And I'm going to make this red. This time I just want to apply it to this card. Now all of the values now highlighted in red are below 100. And all the values above 100 are highlighted green. You can use powerful combinations of color rules to tell a better business story.